know that from my first video about the year review that I mentioned about divorce, and I know I want to talk about, you know, the stuff leading up to it and then the coping, what I did to cope with it. It's still a hard video to put together, and I guess I've been trying to wrap myself around it, and it's just been taking me quite a long time to get to it. So here I am. I'm gonna start doing this today, and I thought that to make it sweeter because it's such a heavy topic, that I'm going to go ahead and start popping these things open, because, you know, when it's like a heavy topic, why not, right? You gotta go with like the sweet stuff. And for those who are health conscious, I have a bowl of strawberries as well. I actually did want to make this video, and I took notes way before, I think maybe like a year ago, because I wanted some of like the thoughts to be fresh in my mind of what I went through versus, like, you know, waiting till today to film. And so I did write down some things so I don't forget what I wanted to say. So I guess this video would have been like 3 years since we've separated. And last January was when we finalized the divorce. So we've been together for about, if you say like at the final divorce, we would have been together for about 10 years, I think, 9 to 10 years. So it's a lot of years to be with one person. And I want to say that when I was in it, this is probably my mistake too, is that I was very sure that, you know, because we were different, but I've always had in my mind, it's like opposites attract, and, you know, just because we're different doesn't mean we can't still, you know, be together. And I think that was probably one of my like setback, or I guess like, I don't know, I don't want to say mistake, but it's just like something that had I looked back on again, like I probably would have like taken my time to get to really know what I want. And also in my mind too at that time, like I was on a timeline, and that's probably another mistake, is to not put yourself on a timeline. I wanted to be like married before I was 30, I wanted to have kids before I was 35, but obviously, you know, all of that goes out the window if you don't have the right person. And at the time I thought he was the right person, you know, we laughed a lot together, you know, we had very different tastes. And we also, and I think fundamentally what we were looking for in each other were also different too, and that's a huge thing. In the end, we found that we were fighting a lot more, and a lot of it also went to the fact that he was busy with school at that time, and I was busy with building my photography career, that we really didn't have time to spend together. And I think, and then that really made things kind of fall apart at that end, because we didn't have enough good substance to keep us together, and we were fighting on top of that too, so all we remembered were the fights. So I think like it made things miserable, especially for him, I think, because he can't, for me, not that like fighting is good, but I grew up in like a family that's pretty like dysfunctional, and to me, like, you know, I see my parents fight all the time, and maybe that's why I thought that it's okay, but that's obviously not okay in a relationship, especially if it's a healthy one. And we can have disagreements, but not like, you know, loud arguments and all that stuff. Like, I don't think that was healthy at all. Also, when we, I think I'm like jumping all over the place, but I really just wanted to talk about communication is very key in a relationship. You guys have to communicate. Me and my boyfriend now, we communicate a lot. In the beginning, I was still very closed off with him because of just the things that I went through in the past, and I just didn't really trust myself to say, like, you know, to just be myself, because I thought being myself would just lead to arguments. Because I think I have a very defensive nature, just from growing up and everything. I've always had a very defensive nature, and always like trying to prove myself, which, you know, when you come to think of it, it's like, who am I trying to prove? You know, it's like, you know, it's him, like, he's not my enemy. So I think that it's been a long journey in learning about each other, but because of our constant communication, it really helped the relationship to grow and to become stronger. And I'm talking about my boyfriend now, not my ex. So tip number one, when you're going through these type of arguments with your spouse, or you're thinking, when is it over? I think the main thing is, if both parties are willing to work it out, then there's a chance to continue. But if one party decides to check out earlier, there's just really no way you could stop them. And for me at that point, I was just like, if he wants to go, go, because I can't force someone to stay in this relationship if they don't want to stay. And I think at that time too, it was also a lot more pride, because I didn't want the relationship to end, because I saw it as a failure on my part, or both parts, I don't know, but I just saw it as a failure, and to break it off to my parents was the worst thing in the world. I think that's also another reason why it's taking me so long to make this video, because I wanted my emotions to be at a point where I can talk about it, but even so, some things still lingers. So know when it's over, because it's just hard to like fight for something that the other person is just not in it with you. Let the person go, and then if it's meant to be, he or she will come around. If it's not, then you are better off with someone else who understands you. At that time, I didn't see it, but definitely now I do see it more so. I'm glad I was able to let him go, because had I not, I wouldn't have met my boyfriend now. And he showed me like what a relationship should be like, and also how much alike that we are. Not that we're like completely 100% alike, but in terms of our wants, our likes, dislikes, he supports me in a lot of what I do. He's always like there for me when I need him, and just he always makes me laugh. Like, he cares for me deep down, which, you know, I even now sometimes I keep thinking to myself, like, you know, why? So, but that's a whole nother issue. So anyways, I'm just kidding. But yeah, so know when to let go, like deep down, just like know when to let go, because bottom line is, don't force someone to stay in a relationship that they don't want to stay in, and open up yourself to potential of a better relationship to come along. So how to cope with your emotions when you find out? Like, cry as hard as you want. There's no rhyme or reason why you can't, because it's emotions, you know. Think of it, and this is what I read before too, is that divorce is like death. It's not the death of a life, but it's a death of a marriage. And you will go through those emotions. You'll go through like denial. You'll go through blaming the other person. You'll go through, you know, like just so many different emotions that will lead you finally to the last step of acceptance. So go through those emotions. Good thing I have a box of tissue. So treat it like death, you know. Don't let it stay forever though, because mourning does have a time limit. Give it some time. Say like, you know, I'm gonna give it like 2 weeks or 3 weeks if you need it. and then pick yourself up and then go from there. Keep your mind occupied after that. Talk to your friends, talk to your family. And I not have friends to nearby to talk to, it would have probably been like a lot harder. But I think at the time, like at least the first week or so, maybe the first week, I just wanted to stay in and not do anything. I forgot about my strawberries. Doesn't food always just make you feel better? Okay. All right. Exercise. Exercise was a big thing. It builds dopamine, which is, you know, that happy little hormone in the body that helps keep you happy, energetic. When you're happy and not sad, people will see that, because that also opens you up to dating too, because who wants to date a sad person, right? Like, who wants to date someone who's like moping and always so sad and crying all the time? Nobody wants to do that. They want to, this is the time that you rediscover yourself. You go and do stuff. You go and find what's interesting to you, what you wanted to do, all you wanted, you know, in the past that you couldn't do. I took piano lessons that I couldn't do it when I was in the marriage because, you know, I had like someone telling me, oh, it's too much money, we can't do this and that and all that stuff. Like, I felt there were limitations. Or I took horse lessons because I've always wanted to, like, horse riding, back, or what's it called, horseback riding lessons. So I took that. I didn't stick with him too long, but because it is expensive, but at least I took it through like Groupons that I found, like deals that I found that I was able to do, and just activities that I wanted to, like, have wanted to do all this time. I think, like, what else did I take? If I remember, I'll come back. Go out with friends. Staying in is good and all, but going out just gets your mind off of the situation at hand. It helps you go and see people, meet people, like new people. If you need to, join a meetup group. I joined a tennis meetup group. I joined a, and this is probably way before too, but I at least reunited back with meetup groups. But tennis, French clubs, I joined that to help with my French. I actually took a month off of work and went to Paris. And I don't know if you guys know that from my videos, but I took a month, what are they called, probations? I'm not sure. But I took a month off to go to Paris because I wanted to always go to Paris to be immersed in the culture and to learn French, or to be more fluent in French. Although I wouldn't say it wasn't still fluent, but at least I did it. I think part of the reason why was because we were traveling a lot during that time, and then also I had friends who stayed with me and we were speaking English still. So, but I did at least try to practice when I can. Also, do things that make you happy, such as for me, the most instant mood lifter is buying flowers. I love flowers. I think it was like either last year or the year before that, but I was buying flowers at least once a week because they make me happy. And just looking at them and seeing how pretty they are and taking in the scent, it all just makes me happy to see that. And I always love flowers. And that was something that I really felt like I didn't really get that much when I was married. And then also remind yourself, like, that there are people who are going through a lot worse than you are. You know, yes, it may seem like it's the end of the world, but it's really not. You know, when you think about it, so many other people are going through a lot much, like, worse than where you are, and there's always going to be a brighter next day. You know, so think of that when you're going through this. And then, you know, one of the best things that I did was also to self-reflect, to see where are some of the things that I can work on myself. And this is a great time to do that, because when you create a life that you want to live in, then people want to share it with you, you know? So this is probably something that I would go through and not just question, but just think, like, is this who I want to be? Is there some things that I can change, such as my communication skills? Because obviously my communication skills can still be changed. Like, I can still have, there's still a lot of room to grow when it comes to my communication skills. There was actually a book that I read called How to Be a Buddhist. And it's actually a really good book, and I'll link it down below. But I actually listened to on my free account on audible.com. I listened to it like 3 times or 4 times a week, multiple times. But I went through and I took the test. You know, I came out to be pretty poor at communicating, and then my boyfriend took the test, and of course he passed it with flying colors. So I was like, dang it. But yeah, I took it. You know, there's just some things that in there that's very helpful to lean on, such as I have to go back and refresh my memory too, but just like three things you have to think about before you say anything, such as number one, you know, are what you're saying true? Number two, is what you're saying kind? And number three, and I always keep forgetting what number three is, but I'll link it down below, and you guys should listen to it. But that really helped me, at least, not that I don't know of these like foundations, but it's a great reminder to go through and do this, because sometimes if you can't tell the other person what you're thinking of, or you can't tell the other person how you feel, how on earth are they going to understand you, you know? So it's just like, it's like a lot of eye-opener things. How to fight insecurities. Do not question why you weren't good enough. That's always a very downhill spiral to nowhere. It will just get you into a lot of trouble. Don't say like you should have fought harder. Don't say that you pushed someone away. These are all questions that, all the questions that I, you know, told myself. And it's not something that you should blame yourself, because not everyone, you know, we just find out that we're better off friends than being married couple. And it's just, there's always going to be someone better for you, you know, just like keep that in mind. There's always going to be someone better. So tips for healthier relationships. Find someone who really loves you for you. That's very important, because don't try to change yourself for just to like fit with the other person, because if it's not a good fit, you're always, what comes naturally to you is going to come out. So no matter if you try to change how, like to fit the person in the beginning, your true self is going to come out later too. So in the end, you're kind of just painting a fake persona of someone that the other person wants you to be, but not necessarily you. So in the end, that will put you in a worse position than you were in the beginning. Always, always, always communicate. That's still number one. True, because without communication, it's just a lot harder to tell each other or just know where you guys stand in a relationship, you know. Be kind to each other. That's like a big thing. And after some time with my boyfriend, and after we've like, you know, reached milestones and whatnot, I find myself to be more like less kind, which is really hard to say, because I think, I don't know if like you girls do the same thing, but like I feel like we're much more nicer to our friends than our boyfriends or our husbands. I'm not sure why. Maybe because we think that, you know, oh, they're gonna be there, you know, it's no big deal. They, I don't know. It's just something that in our mind. But the more kind you are to them, like the more they see that, the more the more things that they'll want to do for you. And from what I read in the past, like, being kind definitely makes the relationship go such a long way. So remember that. Do not keep score. I think that's one thing that it's like, you know, oh, you've done this like how many times, or you've done that. And, you know, keeping score doesn't help anybody. Keeping score, especially when you love each other, do not keep score, because it's all, a relationship is about partnership. So to keep score, you're kind of saying that you're on separate teams, you know, and you're trying to find out who wants to win or who can win this argument or this battle. But really, you guys are on the same team. So why keep score? If anything, you're supposed to keep score of the things that are the positive things, you know. It's like, or for example, it's like how many times that we've gone out together on dates, like once a week or things like that. Or that's some things that you can keep count on, because I think you should go out and have those dates, because it's very important. Don't let those dates falter, because keeping those like things exciting in a relationship just makes it, you know, better. So do not keep score on like frivolous things, especially when it just hurts the relationship versus like, you know, bettering the relationship. And then also give each other space. Space is so important. We realize that, at least especially for me, that I do need sometimes to just like decompress. I have a very I'm a very extrovert person, but I have noticed that I've gone more towards introvert tendencies as I grow older, and so I do like to have my space to decompress. So it's definitely good to have that time alone and just to do the things that you want to do, you know, such as getting your manicure done or getting your lashes done or going out with friends. Like, those things are very important and you should never give that up, especially when you're in a relationship. You should still keep those together for you. I did not eat the whole time except for the two strawberries, but let me actually open up this Ferrero Rocher, so hard to say. So I got this one, and this is, I love their hazelnut chocolate. I don't ever think that I tried the white ones before, so actually let me try that first. Nom nom nom. I have a couple of videos that I actually want to film in the next couple of days, hopefully. But, you know, it's one of those where you have to get into the mood of doing it. But I shouldn't do that. I should just do it. Mmm. Oh, that's super good. Why did I never get that before? It's got like coconut flakes around it, and it's got that same hazelnut center. That was so good. Then we also will open up the Godiva chocolate. Heavy topics, guys. But I hope what I'm saying is helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below and I'll definitely answer to the best of my ability. But everyone's gonna be different. Everyone's gonna go through different ways of coping, but these are just some of the tips that I came upon and really helped me. So I was searching everywhere for these like the Godiva chocolate, because I really love Godiva. I think the Godiva to me is like probably my most favorite compared to all the other chocolate brands out there. And these are like different assorted chocolate nut chews. I think this one's like an almond one. Okay. So, I have last thoughts. Above all else, love yourself, because you need to love the person that you are. If you can't love yourself, how do you expect someone else to love you? You know, because they want to share what you have. They want to share the joy that you feel when you're with yourself, you know, when you can have fun just like being alone and doing what you love. Like, that's who the other person is going to be more attracted to. You know, they're going to be attracted to positivity, to your smile, the radiance that you give off, the energy that you give off. Like, that's someone that you want to attract and stay in your life. I can't tell you how happier I am now that, and looking back, I was just like, you know what, why did I mean, I know why. Like, going through that, it just made me the person who I am today. It made me much stronger. It made me see that, hey, I went through that, and it's still not the end of the world. And the world will still be here the next day, and I can still make it a better life from here on out. You know, it's a beginning of a new chapter. And I know now that I want more of a fulfilling relationship than what I had. So keep that in mind. I hope that these tips were helpful to you. I hope that you can learn from this. Again, if there are any questions, feel free to comment below. If this video was helpful to you, please give it a like. Share it to those who are going through the same thing, and hopefully that they would also be able to prevail and come out of it a stronger person. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.